Hello friends, yes, how are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently friends, we have 12 series that focus on your prelims and one series that target your mains. So what we do in these prelims oriented series, we have basically divided your whole syllabus into 12 large subtopics, and we daily discuss two subtopics, and in this manner, your all 12 subtopics are covered in 6 days. So this process goes on and on in cyclic manner, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam, that is on 31st May, because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC, and we will end this series only on 31st May. So friends, before starting, let me tell you that if you want to join our Telegram channel, then this is the link of our Telegram channel, you can join it, and also this is our email ID. You can in case you want to contact us, you can contact us on this email ID, or for that matter this contact number. And in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, then also you can contact on this email ID or at this number. Let's start a discussion, friends. First question is, consider the following about the role of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. First, he was the founder of Republican Party of India and Swatantrata Party. Second, he was the law minister in the first cabinet of post-independence India. Third, he once acted as the president of Bharatiya Jan Sangh. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is second. That is, he was the law minister in the first cabinet of post-independence India. So the answer would be B. He was the founder of Republican Party, but not of Swatantrata Party. And also he didn't acted as the president of Bharatiya Jan Sangh. The person who acted was someone else. I will not name him here. Solution is B, because that is given in our explanation portion, and those students who want to get the explanation of these MCQs, they can subscribe to the PDFs by contacting at this email ID or at this number. So certainly there will be a minimum cost for subscription friends, but it is kept as minimum as possible for the purpose of our motivation as well as for the purpose of your affordability. So solution is B. Let's move on to the second question. Second question is, consider the following about Vinoba Bhave. First, he undertook Apadi Yatra covering major regions of India to spread Gandhiji's message. Second, he granted the first piece of land to landless villagers. The act later came to be known as Bhudan movement. Third, Gandhi chose Vinoba to be the first satyagrahi during the non-cooperation movement. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that only one statement is correct, and that is first. That is, he undertook Padyatra covering major regions of India to spread Gandhiji's message. And second is not correct. He was not the first person to donate land. He was someone else, and though he started the Bhudan movement. So third is also incorrect, because Vinoba Bhave was not the first satyagrahi during the non-cooperation movement. It was a separate movement in which he became the first satyagrahi. So the answer is one only. So the solution is A. So in detail explanation is in explanation PDF. Let's move on to the third question. Third question is, the residents appointed by the East India Company looked after A, provincial revenue collection; B, administration of madrasas and missionaries; C, implementation of the land tenure system; D, political and commercial affairs of the princely state. So friend, let me tell you friend these residents, the purpose of these residents was to look after the political and commercial affairs of the princely states and to guard the company's interests in these princely states. So the solution is D. Let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, Warren Hastings, the first governor general, introduced several administrative reforms, notably in the sphere of justice. From 1772, a new system of justice was established, under which each district was to have a criminal court and a civil court. Consider the following about it. First, European district collectors presided over criminal courts and interpreted the traditional Indian laws. Second is, civil courts were under the village headman, who was to report to the local Qazi. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are wrong. European district courts presided over the civil courts, and criminal courts were presided over by Qazi and these muftis who were to work under the supervision of district collector. So civil court was directly run by the district collector. So the solution is D, that is, none statement is correct. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, consider the following about the first Supreme Court of India. First, was established under the Indian Courts Act 1861. Second, its first sitting was held in Madras, which was later shifted to Fort William Calcutta. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you friends that both of these statements are wrong, because first Supreme Court of India, it came into force under the Act of 1772, and its first sitting was not held in Madras. It was based on Fort William Calcutta, and first sitting held there. So the solution is D, none. Let's move on to the next question, sixth question. Consider the following about Theosophical Society of India. First, it was established at Adyar in erstwhile Madras. Second, before establishing Theosophical Society in India, Madame Blavatsky's first attempt was to form a similar organization in Cairo. Third, Annie Besant was associated with the party. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that all of these statements are correct. It was established in Adyar, and in fact, before it being established in Adyar, the Madame Blavatsky, she tried to establish a similar organization in Cairo. And also third is also correct. Annie Besant was associated with the society, and also the society reject her friends. Fourth is not correct, because it promoted neuroscience and promoted spiritual practices like meditation. So the correct answer would be C, that is 1, 2, and 3. So the solution is C. Let's move on to the next question, seventh question. Seventh question is, consider the following statements. First, it was the mound burial system of Ahom dynasty. Second, the structural construction and the process of royal burials are explained in historical documents called Changdrong Pokhanur Buranji. Third, the property and buffer zones are jointly protected and managed jointly by the Archaeological Survey of India and the State Department of Archaeology. So here we have been asked that which site we are talking about, that is Moidam, Burzahom, Narkondam, Lamjano. Let me tell you, friends, that the site is A, that is Moidam. So solution is A. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, Gandhiji was invited to the inauguration of Banaras Hindu University. His speech there is considered important from many viewpoints. The speech included which of the following? First, he criticized the use of English in the forum. Second, he admonished the Maharajas for stealing and concentrating wealth away from the poor. Third, he asked the attendee Viceroy to leave India and return back to England. So we have to choose the correct statement. Let me tell you, friends, that all of these statements are correct. Gandhi was invited to the inauguration ceremony of Banaras Hindu University, which was established in as Central Hindu College in 1898 by Annie Besant, but later upgraded to Banaras Hindu University. So solution is D, that is 1, 2, and 3. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is ninth question. Commercialization of agriculture was one of the major policies of British Empire in rural India. What do you understand by this term? First, land reforms for revenue, greater revenue generation. Second, agricultural production for sale in the market. Third, making tenants the sole owner of the land. So we have to choose that which of the following refers to the commercialization of agriculture. Let me tell you, friends, that the correct answer is second only. The agriculture production for sale in the market. So this is the chief feature of commercialization of agriculture. So only second statement is correct. So the answer would be B, that is second only. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, one of the major important characteristics of Indian foreign trade throughout the colonial period was the generation of a large export surplus. This was achieved largely by A, exploitative colonial policies that used the surplus to fund their trade, B, near zero duties on cash crops and textile industry in India, C, policy of discriminating protection granted to select industries since 19th century, D, growing share of industrial activity during the colonial regime. So there was export surplus, friends, there was a large generation of export surplus. It was largely achieved by exploitative colonial policies that used the surplus to fund their trade. So the solution is A. So this is all about, friends, today's lecture. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then please do hit a like, do subscribe to our channel, and also do not forget to press the bell icon, because then only you will get all the important notifications relating to UPSC CHSE 2019. So friends, in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, that is explanation PDFs, which are in detail explanation of why a particular option is correct and why a particular option is not correct, then you can contact us on this email ID, that is achieveies21@gmail.com, or at this contact number, that is 8968426481. So certainly there will be a minimum cost for the explanation PDFs, but that has been kept only for the purpose of our motivation as well as your affordability. So it is not that much. So in case you want to subscribe to the explanation PDF, you can contact us at this email ID or at this number. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you, friends. Have a very nice day. Thank you.